reading from Daniel. Then I turned to the Lord God to seek an answer by prayer and supplication, with fasting and sackcloth and ashes. I prayed to the Lord my God and made confession, saying, Ah, Lord, great and awesome God, keeping covenant and steadfast love with those who love you and keep your commandments, we have sinned and done wrong, acted wickedly and rebelled, turning aside from your commandments and ordinances. We have not listened to your servants, the prophets, who spoke in your name to our kings, our princes, and our ancestors, and to all the people of the land. Righteousness is on your side, O Lord, but open shame, as at this day, falls on us, the people of Judah, the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and all Israel, those who are near and those who are far away, in all the lands to which you have driven them, because of the treachery that they have committed against you. Open shame, O Lord, falls on us, our kings, our officials, and our ancestors, because we have sinned against you. To the Lord our God belong mercy and forgiveness, for we have rebelled against him and have not obeyed the voice of the Lord our God by following his laws, which he set up before us by his servants, the prophets. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from John. Then Jesus cried aloud, Whoever believes in me believes not in me, but in him who sent me. And whoever sees me sees him who sent me. I have come as light into the world so that everyone who believes in me should not remain in the darkness. I do not judge anyone who hears my words and does not keep them. For I came not to judge the world, but to save the world. The one who rejects me and does not receive my word has a judge. On the last day, the word that I have spoken will serve as judge. For I have not spoken on my own, but the Father who sent me has himself given me a commandment about what to say and what to speak. And I know that his commandment is eternal life. What I speak, therefore, I speak just as the Father has told me. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
creature and sky. We have not honored the divine in all of creation. We have forgotten our origins, believing ourselves superior to the very earth from which you formed us. Humble us, God. Remind us how young we are in comparison to the cosmos. Make us hear and heed the quiet stirrings that say this land does not belong to us. May we see you in tree and star and soil and become Earth's meekest disciples and fiercest protectors. In your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all who tremble, courage can feel foolish when we've seen the world in all its terror. Protect us from lives lived in perpetual vigilance. Keep fear from monopolizing our relationships, our desires, our motivations, so that we can act without rehearsing the worst of our imaginations. Help us meet fear with kindness and mercy. Slow our breath. Ground our attention that love might reign in our lives. In your mercy, hear our prayer. God of solidarity, you enter the suffering of our world. Guide us toward a solidarity that demands something of us. Teach us to risk ourselves on behalf of the vulnerable, for when one of us is harmed, we all are. Help us to discover justice and liberation are not scarce, that our survival and dignity are wrapped up in one another. Steady in us the will to stand, knowing together we can join you in repairing and restoring what society has destroyed and demonized. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Oh,
to the God who is well acquainted with the wilderness and who never abandons us to its trials or temptations. And the blessing of this Holy One, who loves, forgives, and redeems all things, be with you now and always. Amen.